So I was debating on how I wanted to tell Garrett the news. I had known for about 4 days that I was pregnant and I wanted to do something extra special. We were on safari in Africa and we had just found out that we were on our way to see 3 baby lions. So I wrote up a quick message to our safari guide and it basically just said, I'm pregnant, Garrett doesn't know, I want you to like mention it when we see these 3 baby lions. And our guide was awesome. Thank you so much, Taylor.
She did such a good job.
Because she just kind of goes silent. Like, I think it made her super nervous. And she only had like 10 minutes to like...
She was so cute about it. She's like, that was the first time I've ever been involved in a baby announcement.
It was awesome. So anyway, I mean, watch the clip. It's the cutest.
So you can see the one there. So there's one little baby lion by Dorothy. And there's another little one. And who's going to be that? There's going to be you. But then, Manila, there's going to be a third little one.
There's three?
There's three. So who's the third one going to be?
I think it's okay. Mommy's tummy.
We're just your average family who is choosing to live a not-so-average life. We decided to sell everything and leave our home for an adventure around the world. And now, we are the Bucket List Family. Garrett, Jessica, Dorothy, Manila, and Callie. Welcome to our family adventure. Where are we off to next?
Oh my God.
Go for it, Manila. Kiss the plane, buddy. Yeah. Callie, where you at?
Daddy, do you even know how to drive a plane?
There's only one way to find out, Dorothy. This is just go for it. You're holding on?
What's that?
You're gonna want your buckle extra tight for this one.
But I don't know how to tie.
So your clients, your visitors that are coming to TAASA, what would you suggest they do?
Well, what they do is most of the times people don't just come and stay for a while, like they're on a 14 day.
All right, ladies and gents, this is your captain speaking.
Go for it. Continue.
White lights lead to red lights and exit signs, which indicate the exit.
Good morning from Tanzania.
All right, guys, so Tanzania is country number 3 that is going to inspire our future home. What section of the house? Or should they just tune into the show?
Just tune in the show.
A few years ago, we sold everything to travel the world.
And now we're setting out on our biggest adventure yet.
Home.
While we're out gathering inspiration in amazing countries each week,
our at-home experts, Andy and Candace,
Hi.
Will remodel our new home.
Not our house yet.
In real time.
Room by room.
We'll need your help too.
You decide what we experience in each country.
Wow.
We're asking you to help us plot our course, live.
This is your invitation to join us on this journey.
In
traveling home.
I feel like you're off key.
You're not singing it.
After you watch this video, go click on the link below to the Traveling Home Show by Home Love Network. And
this will be the third episode. I hope you guys have seen the first two, because we haven't.
Yeah.
We haven't seen anything yet. And it's just killing us inside, because to know that our home is there and we just could see it if we would just click.
Okay, but go watch it.
All right, we are on the amazing continent of Africa, within the amazing country of Tanzania, and here in the area of the Great Serengeti.
So if you want to experience the Serengeti, there's a few different ways to go about it.
You can stay like within the Serengeti, or you can also stay just outside of the Serengeti, and that's what we did at this magical place called TAASA. We didn't know this coming here, but there's actually a lot of benefits to staying just outside of the Serengeti. What are they?
The Serengeti is a national park. So with that, there's a few rules. You have to stay on the roads, and there's only specific hours that you can be in the park.
You can't go in too early, and then you have to come in before dark.
Which on safari is actually when all the action happens.
Right?
So
early in the morning is when they're hunting and eating, and after dark, like, we really love seeing the wildlife, like, in the heat of the action. And so fortunately, if you're staying just outside of the Serengeti, some of those rules don't apply. And the Serengeti, like, it's not a zoo. There's no, like, gates or fences or any of that.
Yeah.
And so the animals, like, they don't know the difference. They are just everywhere around and about. And so if you're just outside of the Serengeti, is this area called the concession.
It's a special piece of land,
right,
that the government has set aside purely for conservation.
So it's protected, but there aren't those same rules. And so when we're out on these game drives, out on the safari, we are there early in the morning, late at night, just
and you can get
the most
up close to these animals. So super raw, and you're just one with Africa.
I didn't see what's over there. It's been wild.
Yeah, and it's totally a game changer. I mean, when you're up at 5 a.m. and there's so much going on at 5 a.m.
Well, let's explain to them, like, the day-to-day process, how it goes, okay?
So this is how safari works out here at TAASA. You wake up super duper early.
Like 5:30.
Yeah. Someone knocks on your door and they bring you
hot chocolate, tea. And usually it would be, like, hard to wake up. But when your mind finally is like, hey, guess what? You're in Africa. Get out of bed.
Get up, because the lions are awake. So we jump out of bed and we hop in the car.
And it's kind of chilly. I mean, it's winter here. And the coolest thing was to see how well the kids did. I mean, imagine this. Imagine someone telling you, hey, we're going to take your young kids and you're going to put them in a car and you're just going to be in the car and it's going to be cold and this car ride's going to be 4 hours, 5 hours. Like,
we hate road trips.
Sounds miserable, right?
Yes.
But not here. Like, you're in this open air Land Cruiser and you're just cruising all around the wild. The kids were just so amused the whole time.
Yeah, they were engaged. They were looking right for stuff. Like, it was a ton of fun.
But how cool is that? Especially nowadays for parents. Like, it's not like they were playing on their phones. Playing on iPad. Like, a 4 to 6 hour road trip. None of that. Just nature, fresh air. I was in heaven.
I love giraffes.
Mom, it's eating the tree.
It's eating the tree.
And then the sun goes down and you stop and you have a little break. You have some drinks.
Like a little campfire.
A little campfire.
Tell some stories.
Which is really fun. Yeah, hearing some campfire stories from our guide was so fun.
Our guides come from the Massai village. And the Massai village is the craziest nomadic culture with the craziest, most insane stories. Should we even tell them the stories? Let's edit the words. Okay. So
no, to become a man, you have to kill a lion. Actually, you don't anymore. Laws have changed. But
like the original culture, like to
Maasai
become a
men,
man, yeah.
You have to kill a lion. So hearing all these lion killing stories.
Well, and then there's this other thing where you have to have a certain operation if you're a man. An operation makes it sound like it's happening in a hospital, but it's not. And they would put chili peppers on like the thing to do it. And it would, because the whole purpose, I don't know what the purpose was, but it's to be prove you were a man?
Yeah.
No way. Okay.
Garrett's not.
So
he's gonna go ahead
when
and say
you, if you were the man having this operation done at the age of 17, then, oh my gosh, I would lie to my age so hard.
You get circumcised and you cannot show whatsoever any sign of pain or...
You're not allowed to blink.
or you're shunned.
So no blinking, no flinching, no crying, or you are shunned for life. You are known as a weakling. And even when he said, like, so if they go around at dinner and they, like, fill your glass, they'll fill it just halfway because, oh, yeah, you blinked that one time. The pressure.
Yeah.
What is that all about? Is that crazy? Every night we're around this campfire just hearing these crazy stories from the Maasai people.
And at the same time, you're like, didn't we just see lions, like, 200 yards from here? Okay, so we've had a few favorite moments this week in Tanzania.
What was yours?
My
favorite? Too hard to pick.
Oh, jeez. What is yours? Soccer?
Oh, man. Dear father back home.
Dear Joji.
I could have been circumcised and not flinched based off of how I performed in that soccer game.
Okay, so it was really fun. Right. So the staff at TAASA every day goes out and plays soccer on this pitch that is in the middle of...
This soccer field is just
the Serengeti. There.
There's the land of the Serengeti, and there are the wildebeest and the zebras, and then there's this soccer field. The whole time, like, anytime the ball would go out of bounds, I'd be like, you go ahead and get it.
You'd kill a lion.
Probably a lion in that bush.
No, but it was so fun. We all played. You had to avoid some of, like, the wildebeest droppings. But it was so fun. The kids played, and it was just a blast. And at the end of the game...
was the most buckless moment of my entire life.
Garrett challenged the Tanzanians to a foot race.
Just making my father so proud. Will you explain to people why my father will never see this video?
Garrett's father...
does not have internet yet.
...lives in a different century.
He's basically Maasai.
Yeah. He lives in a different century. He doesn't use a lot of technology. He's not super tech savvy.
But if anyone ever shows this video to my father, I just gotta say, dear father, I made you proud because I foot raced the Tanzanian people, like 16 of them.
Yeah.
And it was, okay, we're gonna go 1, 2, 3, go. Side note, they don't speak English.
Side note, so they're, and they're cheaters,
1, 2, and then they just took off. And you see me like, what? Everyone's gone. And then I took off like a cheetah.
And Garrett beat the Tanzanians, and he was so proud. And I'm sure they were like, who is this boy? Because he's not white, and he's not African like us. Like, what is this?
I'm a cheetah.
Woo! Yeah! Hey, girl. Run me! Give her high fives, Mia. High fives. High fives. Yeah, now him too. Yeah, good job.
Where's Garrett?
He's coming. We're doing Mzungos versus Tanzanians. Mzungos means white people.
What team am I on?
You're white.
Okay.
American. Last time you played soccer.
When was the last time I played soccer?
I think it was kind of recent. Where was it? Brazil?
Guatemala.
This
is, how did I not play soccer in Brazil?
No,
it's because they wouldn't let me. Where did we just recently play?
Ecuador. Yeah. All right.
Mr. Worldwide.
Do you got these Tanzanians, babe? They are tall.
They look pretty legit.
They look fast.
Right?
I think we should have a foot race after this.
Oh, foot race for sure.
Careful of the
wildebeest poop.
Wildebeest poop.
Oh, foot race for sure. Leave some percentage for foot race.
Okay.
A bunch of Tanzania in the Serengeti.
This place, this experience is hands down my favorite in all of our travels. Safari is unbelievable. It's the only thing in the world that I'll wake up at 5 a.m. for and just like jump out of
bed. True story.
And we are super excited because we want to share this experience with you. And we're actually going to do it in a few different ways. We're going to give a trip to TAASA to a family. So stay tuned for more information on this gift, because man, there are going to be some lucky
And it's
ducks.
Not just like an opportunity to come to Africa and be on a safari, it's an opportunity to come here to TAASA, which we believe is just one of the absolute best experiences you can have anywhere in the world.
Okay, but also, we're for sure going to do a group expedition here.
Because we're coming back, and you can come with us.
This place has become a home away from home. The staff here and the owners here are amazing people, and we're stoked to go back. So, again, stay tuned for more information, one, on a giveaway, and two, to join us, because we'll be back here most likely in 2018.
Thank you for watching. We hope you enjoyed all of the wildlife. We hope you are definitely scared to foot race me in the future.
Your dad's going to be so proud.
I hope so. This is the first thing. How long ago was the last time I saw my father?
I don't know.
It's been a while.
It's been too long.
Father, I miss you. And when I see you, the first thing I'm going to tell you is, did it, Dad. I foot raced the Tanzanian, and I won.
Okay, until next week.
Bye.
Can you feel the love?